Hello, this is Taureor, and welcome back to Let's Play Europa Universalis IV as Poland in our Polish domination campaign, and we are in a bunch of wars. All kinds of things are happening, and it looks like we're losing, but we're really not. Maybe against Spain, but it's more of a, you know, we just didn't do anything about it. We will soon retake our land, and then conquer all of Iberia, quickly. Alright then, now I'm waiting for Gallery to be sieged, so I can full annex them. Let's just unpause. We do have a free diplomat. I should be improving relations with somebody. We do have a small vassal of Sicily. I will be improving relations with them, so we can possibly annex them before the end of the game. But that would need being at peace for a little while, and I don't know if we will be at peace, at least for a moment. Alright. So, this is going well. This is going better. And this is going alright as well. Still need to siege some of those things. I could actually sign a peace treaty with Brabant already. But I would... yeah, I need more war score if I want Ghent. And I do want Ghent. All the coast. Unfortunately, well, without Utrecht, because that's too much war score. But still. Okay, let's continue. I'm currently trying to siege Portugal quickly. To just get everything and get out of the war. And then we will focus on taking care of Spain. Just need to retake our forts. They will automatically re-siege the land. Yeah, Gallery wants peace again. You're not getting it, Gallery. We were in the negatives with prestige for a long time because of this war, but now we are recovering quite nicely. Alright, so... this will still take some time. If you did take the two provinces over here, so I think we should consolidate you and get you a leader, and now attack the Spanish army, just to get it out of the way. Then do some besieging of our forts taken by Spain. They took Alicante. Oh, it's fine. Well, let's kill this Portuguese army. We are much better in terms of military. They don't stand a chance. They did survive, though. Where are you running to? Sevilla. Yeah, let's just wipe them. Another conversion successful. Great, we get some free papal points. Not that we need them anymore. Right, this is taken. And this fort is relatively small. We just split those armies to take the two forts at the same time. And this is going to take some time. Gallery, Utrecht and Brabant are still being... that's not Brabant, that's Limburg. Yeah, they're still being sieged. Portugal actually wants peace treaty now. No, sorry Portugal, but I do want all your possessions in the Iberian Peninsula. And I doubt that you will want to accept that just yet. We do have some rebels rising up very soon because of all the lands occupied by our enemies. But when we're done with the wars, we'll just use those troops to get rid of the rebels. Cardinal exposed, sure, whatever. Well, those things keep happening because the Pope hates us. Aggressive expansion, 388. That's a lot. Right. Because we don't have trouble with rebels in the provinces that we control because of our awesome ideas. Alliance with Congo. Did the rebellion happen? Oh, yes, it did. Oh, good. They will besiege the province for us. Wonderful. Portugal occupied the Ivory Coast. Right. We have some stuff here. Well, when we have taken their capital and the forts in this area, they should be willing to give us everything. We'll just have to wait long enough. Oh, and we have everything now. Yeah. We will have to wait now until they get some... until we accumulate war score for controlling their capital, and until they get war exhaustion. You guys should besiege the fort. It'll not take a long time. Siege of Trebizond. No, Ethiopia is coming. Right, what should I do with you guys? Probably siege Toledo. Yeah, this is going slowly but well. Now, how about those provinces? Come on, Gallery, fall. A siege leader would be an asset in this place. Let's get the next level of military technology and then roll some leaders. So we can get, you know, a siege one. Wonderful. Two siege. Perfect. 7% and it's going to change to 21%. Much, much better. Alright, I was supposed to give you more cannons. Did I not give you more cannons? I did, but not enough. Can you spare some cannons? Give me some cannons. Just want to make this quicker. Then you'll get them back. So, 28% now. Better. Blockade. Lose admin power or local unrest? Local unrest. Yeah, rebels are rising up everywhere. Only in the provinces that are occupied by our enemies. And they will be taken back soon. The colony has been damaged but not destroyed, and that's all that matters. Right. Can I get you guys out of here? Will the colony survive? Because I would like to recall some people. Those should survive, even if they get attacked. How many do we have at the moment? We have 9 colonies. Okay, so I'm not sending any new guys. That's too expensive. How's the siege going? It's going. Should probably snipe this army in Zaragoza. Oh, we have taken Toledo, wonderful. Do you have any more forts, Spain? Not really. You only have the ones that you control that belong to us. Okay, so I'll do a carpet siege. That's 8 provinces. Come on, come on. Let's split them. Many, many times. So I'll also do a carpet siege of the stuff that belongs to us, but is occupied by them. Come on, come on. Yeah, it's a lot of micromanagement. Alright. This will be retaken by the fort, so we don't need to spend troops on that. This is another sieger. Right, here and here and here. Now all the Spanish provinces. Mancha, Jaen, something like that. Great, and this will be re-sieged. Go to Murcia. We don't need that many troops here. I will detach a siege and send you to Valencia. And that's it, basically. Okay, great, new fort, gain castle. I don't mind. I don't need it, but I don't mind. Portugal, are you ready to give me all your possessions? No. We occupied this place. Okay, let's keep sending them to other places. When they're done, even though they would be besieged by the forts, this way it's quicker. La Mancha and Salamanca. Where's Salamanca? Okay then, and where are you going? Well, they are retreating, so we should win. Will we? Might not. I'll send them some reinforcements. Right, and you should be enough. If they can survive. They couldn't survive until the reinforcements came. Now they will. Oh, come on. You have a good general, but you have no morale. Okay, we won. Finally. How are the sieges? Very slow, apparently. That's 12 progresses still. Cotton, great. Ethiopia wants a white piece. I don't really want anything from Ethiopia, so you can have your white piece, Ethiopia. And now we are at 76% war score with revolutionary Spain. What I want from them is everything in the Iberian Peninsula, so they might be reluctant. Well, they're not reluctant at all. don't really need anything else from you. And you won't give me anything else because you have all the forts that I would need to sail and siege. Hooray! Alright, wonderful. Great. So give me all your money. I suppose I could vassalize Spain. No. Vassalizing a revolutionary Spain would be interesting. Oh, I think there's an achievement for having high war score against a revolutionary country, so let's wait a little bit longer so the war score can increase. Also, we are overextended at the moment, so we can't really take all that land that we would want to take. Spain can wait. Right, excellent diplomat. Prestige or diplopower? Actually, I'll take prestige this time. Okay, occupied some provinces. Wonderful. Colony self-sustaining. Do you have any provinces we should be sieging but are not sieging? This one. And Gibraltar. So we can start retaking those things. And this still doesn't want to happen. Okay, war score is increasing. We do control their capital, so it will keep rising up. Gallery wants a peace treaty. I don't want a peace treaty with Gallery, but we did get call for peace because of Spain. Could become a bit problematic. Oh, Pexico has 100% liberty desire. Really? Does that mean they will declare independence immediately when we are out of wars? Possibly, I don't know. I don't want to risk it. Portugal is still not ready to accept our demands. Seems like we'll have to keep declaring wars. To be at war all the time. Come on guys, finish it. I need to deal with the rebels. Taureor has been cored. Right, Brabant is probably still not ready to accept my terms. Yeah, they're still not ready to accept my terms. We can wait. Siege of Granada is over. Great. So we actually have some troops that can fight rebels now. I will also use all of you. And you. Oh, you can take Cantabria. Right, you do your thing. We'll take those guys. Great Britain, would you like a peace treaty? White peace, possibly? No. Never mind then. Right. Oh, let's check the colonial situation. How many colonies do we have? We have 8 colonies. That is alright. Some natives, but we do have an army there. Yeah, those are progressing very slowly because of the aggressive natives. Okay. Makassar occupied Terek. Sure, whatever. Time to retake some French lands. Possibly buy down war exhaustion. We don't need to right now, but we could do it. Okay, is there anything we don't control here? There is, but it is being taken care of. Alright, so let's just start re-sieging provinces, and in the meantime, we will deal with the enemy. Siege of Gallery is over, finally. Okay, full annexation. Annex Gallery. Should I start another war? Do you have a truce with me? You do. Are there any truces about to expire? Okay, with the whole coalition next year, so we will have to start some wars so they don't gang up on us. Okay, I will use those guys to destroy the rebels. Gallery accepted our generous peace offer, and we can now start coring the province. We are still far from being overextended. Only 70% of extension, and a lot of cores are about to be completed. How is this going? 5? 12? Oh, you don't have cannons, of course you don't have cannons. Wait, we lost something. We lost a battle. Where was that? Oh, here probably. Yeah, an army must have reached this place before the big one did. Right, colony self-sustaining. And we do have a free colonist right now, so let's send him somewhere. Those are not very aggressive, so we will send a colonist there and recall him. And we can get a new military advisor. I will take the morale one, because morale is good. Westphalia, Austria, and Hungary don't have heirs. War exhaustion. Yeah. I think we have to stay at war all the time. Is that because of... Yeah. Better diplomatic technology. Tariffs, administrative efficiency. Oh, administrative efficiency increases liberty desire. Interesting, didn't know that. Okay, returning. We'll just keep fighting until the end of the game. We can handle that. Although I'm not sure if I want to peace out Spain, because with Spain in a war against us, we get such bonuses to unrest that call for peace means nothing to us. We'll see. For now we have other stuff to worry about. Right, so I will detach a small siege here. Move guys to all the provinces. Are you moving anywhere? Oh, I must have clicked something. No, I didn't. Let's just go kill the army in the in Orleans. Yeah, consolidate you guys. Detach a siege, and do I really need to? When we peace out Brabant, this will fall. No, I'll just merge those guys, split them in half, send half here and half here because they need cannons. And this will become ours immediately when we peace out Brabant. And our war score will increase dramatically when we have taken the remaining fortresses. Do we have enough cannons here? How many do we need? We need 20, we have 18. And that's close enough. Tariffs on salt. No tariffs. Only self-sustaining in this place. Right. I was supposed to send and retract the colonist somewhere in here. I suppose he's probably still traveling. Yes, he is. Alright, you all want peace treaties? I'm not giving you peace treaties. Suppose I could sign a peace treaty with Spain, but it's so nice having all those bonuses. Also, can we handle the overextension right now? We're at 70, so we can't. Not at the moment. Although it would be nice to get rid of the call for peace. We can always declare war on them again. They will still exist. We occupied Périgord, which is... Oh, we occupied Utrecht. Wonderful. Are you willing to give me what I want now? You are. Wonderful. Can I get anything else from you? Not really. I mean, I could take Utrecht, but that's better. Okay, also give me some cash. No, that would be overextension. I'll need to wait for the overextension to dissipate, then I will take it. Because we're at 70%, we just need to wait September, so a couple months. Right. Or we could just peace out Spain so we don't get the call for peace. I suppose we'll probably get call for peace anyway. Right. Great Britain, would you like to sign a peace treaty? White peace. No? Not yet. And you guys can actually move out of this place and... So we take the rebel provinces? Let's just kill the rebels here. Although they are besieging it. Soft answer turns away truth. Free conversion. Whatever. You can sample new religions, I do not mind. Oh, they completed the siege and we will take it from them. Shortly, because the garrison has not recovered. Right, can I assault immediately? Not immediately. The call for peace is quite severe. Probably signing a peace treaty with Spain would be better. And the coalition is about to have the truce expire. Yeah, maybe I should sign a peace treaty with Spain when I'm able to handle the overextension. Some cores have been completed, the overextension is 35%. If I take what I want, it will be 72%. So too much. Too much. Still too much. When's the next core? Oh, very soon. Wait a little while longer. Come on, finish. October. Timurids want access. Sure, Timurids, you can have it. I'm just curious what you have in mind. Let's kill the revolutionary rebels, then we can distribute the troops sieging provinces. We have taken Liège. We don't really need to take the forts. Though they are low-level forts. I'll just take the rebel provinces, it's more pressing. How long until this finishes? Bloody hell. Koblenz is now a core province, and now we can annex Spain. Let's do that. We will declare war on them as soon as we can. That will give us a few more years of the... Oh, wait a minute. I was supposed to wait for the war score to increase so I could get the achievement. Okay. Let's do it then. I will take stuff from Brabant instead. Or from Portugal, if they agree. That means we will have to endure core for peace for a longer period of time, but still. Will the call for peace reset when I take stuff from Brabant? You're not willing to give us anything more than that. Or are you? No? That's fine. I can live with that. So, coring. Also, autonomy, because they are quite rebellious here in the Netherlands. Am I actually having trouble with rebels? Provincial unrest. Yeah, it's all the provinces that are taken by the enemy. Oh, and we do have some separatists. Core. Let's just use the coring screen over here. Make a core. Yeah, they're pretty expensive because of the high development. We're running out of admin. Brabant is no longer a valid rival. Wonderful. And the call for peace did not reset, unfortunately. Oh, crap. Okay then, we'll have to sign another peace treaty. Frankfurt. Who else is in the war? Only Frankfurt. Okay, I will sign a peace treaty with Frankfurt then. I can't core this province, so I don't want it. Give me money and that's it. I'll force your religion. Yeah, I'll force religion just to get the prestige. And the unrest is gone in most provinces. So yeah, just take the rebel provinces back. And you can focus on other wars. Which is handy because we're about to declare some more. Just so the coalition doesn't eat us up. Who should we take? Possibly Savoy, Bavaria, Bohemia, Lorraine, and Brabant. That's a lot. Lorraine, Bavaria, Savoy, and Brabant. Bavaria, Savoy, and Brabant. That's a lot. Westphalia. Great Britain, Württemberg. We are already with at war with Great Britain. That could be a good idea. February next year. What about Austria? That's a longer truce. Venice. Yeah, Venice is a good idea. Knights and Genoa. We could declare a separate war against Venice. How are we doing on the overextension front? We're doing fine. When it's done, we'll annex some more stuff. Portugal, are you ready to be taken into our, you know, country? Almost. I don't really want anything apart from those provinces, so we only have to wait a little while. Oh, you guys need to get into our territory. Okay then. So it was, the conquering spree is a thing. There are some revolutionaries in Moldavia, we should probably take care of that. Portugal wants a peace treaty. Portugal, won't you like the peace treaty that I have prepared for you? Also, how much of extension? 45 of extension. I cannot handle 45 of extension right now. so it will have to wait. It can even wait a very long, long time. I'm in no hurry. I don't really need to fight any more wars in the HRE, but I don't want the coalition to attack me, so I will probably declare a separate war against Westphalia, separate war against Venice, possibly. We'll think about it. For now, let's use this army to destroy the revolutionaries in Ferrara. Or I could just destroy the Pope. He hates me. What about Kazan? April 1801. And how's the colonial front? Oh, I actually managed to move those troops here. Okay then. Suppose I can recall those colonists. Let's split you up. Move you to the dangerous regions and the ones that are being colonized currently. Here and here. And you'll go here. We'll send some troops, some colonists there. And how many colonies do we have at the moment? We have 6 colonies and 2 are traveling. I can afford one more to be recalled. To recall you. Hope you survive. Send you over here. Wonderful. We have occupied Normandy from the rebels. All the rebel influences have been destroyed. I'll actually reduce war exhaustion a little bit. Okay, it's fine. Now we just need to wait for the truces to end, and I should probably merge those guys in Paris and, you know, redistribute the armies and all that. While this big army will deal with the revolutionaries here, I don't need that many troops in it. I'll just split you in half. You'll deal with these revolutionaries and then with the ones in Moldavia. Right, I don't remember the exact details of the achievement. I think, oh, Moldavia has pretty high war exhaustion. I believe it might be 99 war score while at war with a revolutionary country and holding their capital. If it is so, we can certainly wait and get that. Especially since we get such a nice bonus for being at war with them. Although the call for peace is quite problematic. Monthly war exhaustion plus 0.10. We don't really need to peace people out that much. Is it already time to start the Palatinate at Bohemia entered the coalition, and some truces have expired? A truce with the Ottomans? What other truces? Palatinate and Bohemia have been pieced out separately. Maybe it's a good idea to conquer them. Allied with Württemberg, and yeah, you know what? I'll actually declare war on the Palatinate right now. Although that will call in Austria as the emperor, and Austria is allied with Hungary, Great Britain, Tyre, and Württemberg. So that will be another big war. Fortunately, I can afford it. Let's do it. Here we go. We'll have Bohemia, Austria, and some other guys. Unfortunately, that means I can't send you guys to fight rebels, because you have other, better stuff to do. Like, actually, fight our enemies. Let's see who is in the war. Yeah, Great Britain is still our enemy, doesn't really matter. Okay, we'll start with those guys. And I think we will embrace the call for peace. And stay in the wars forever. When's the end of the campaign? 1821, right? Yeah, that's how long we'll stay at war. So now, even if a bunch of truces have expired, that means a new coalition will form out of those countries. Maybe we should start a separate war. Can't really do it right now. I'm pretty busy. Savoy entered the coalition. And Genoa entered the coalition. And what about Hungary? Allied with Austria and the Papal State. I could declare one Hungary until, well, before they joined the coalition. Westphalia and Lorraine have joined. Bavaria has entered. And the Papal State. If I declare one Hungary, that would... Let's hope they don't join the coalition. Let's hope they're afraid. I could fight the Papal State by declaring war on Hungary. So what shall we do? Siege those places. Venice has entered into the coalition, and Hungary has. Oh, that's a pity. I wanted to fight them separately. Alright then. So, how many troops do we need here? None. And this is a small garrison, and so is this. Alright, let's leave a very small token force. Get some of you up here. The rest down here. It will be very... those will be very quick sieges. And this time I will try not to separate my forces too much. We should start by taking Berg. I think I'll just reach 20 war exhaustion and see what happens if we stay at 20 war exhaustion. Because with the nice bonuses to unrest, we should be able to handle it. I would like a theologian, though, because the unrest reduction will be necessary. Also need to increase stability. Permanent war mode activated. Let's split you guys up in half. Send you to Berg. Are we fighting anybody else in the north? Not really. Alright, let's leave you guys here. And you can go to Augsburg. No, you will be too vulnerable there. You can stay where you are. This siege will be over in no time. Yeah, some natives, not a problem. We'll start with those guys and then... and then... Bohemia. Okay, wonderful. And they're actually coming to attack us. Is this a mountainous province? That's the main question. It is not. We should retreat to a mountainous province if they decide to attack. Is there one here? Not really. Nowhere around here, really. Oh, and we do have the manpower and the money. So, mercenaries. And possibly some cannons. We have a lot of cannons, but still. And some cavalry. Use the manpower, you know. Some infantry as well. That'll be sufficient for now. We are suffering attrition, but it's not a big deal. If we get attacked, we have some decent generals, and we will get some reinforcements. This is not a big fortress. I'll just detach a siege. And possibly get back here. I could just snipe the army that Trier has up here. Yeah, that could be a good idea. They're going to Tyrol. Okay, I will let them roam around here, and then we will strike from the north. Occupying Bohemia. Can I get you before you run away? Not really. Okay, let's get you down there, because we need to keep our forces together. We will suffer attrition, but that's not a big problem. When did Hungary join the war? Were we allied with somebody? Suppose I could separate peace Britain, but I don't care that much. Right, so we are in the endgame, the permanent war mode. Well, the Palatinate has two provinces, really? Oh, right, because the Palatinate is the war leader, that's the thing. This is Austria. Good, we took it. And we do need a leader in that army. Here, have a siege leader. I suppose I could attack, but I would like to use all my forces when I do. Can I build a fort here? Can I actually build provinces? I'm building into the provinces that I don't own. What if I destroy those? I can't. Doesn't really matter. Yeah, those armies are too big for their own good. I suppose I could assault. We'll lose some infantry, but it will be quicker. Also, it is time to end the episode, so let's just wait for this to finish. Wonderful. And yeah, it's time to end. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you did enjoy the video. If you did, please click the like button. And I will see you very soon. Goodbye.